forms that it takes, and how it targets particular populations and constituencies. Now, in the history of black people, it was a modern invention. It had been a long period in which there were no slavery. There was a vicious treatment of serfs and so forth and feudalism. But it was a modern invention. And it was tied to capitalism on the one hand, and it was tied to a systematizing of an ideology of white supremacy. Now, our beloved scholar here, Walter Johnson, calls it racial capitalism, following Cedric Robinson and W. Boyce and others. I call it a slaveholding capitalist civilization. And so here, under modern conditions, a capitalist mode of production on a global scale, the Lancashire mills, cotton picked in the South with unbelievable profits, 22% of the inhabitants of the 13 colonies, enslaved Africans, generating the wealth, which is a precondition for the fragile democratic experiment after the land is dispossessed and indigenous people to violate. So that the presupposition, slavocratic realities for democratic possibilities. Now, white supremacy becomes now systematic. What does systematic mean? Churches, mosques, synagogues, universities, scientific communities, mass media, all come together and say black people are less than human. That black people are less intelligent, less moral, less beautiful. And to try to convince black people that black history is a curse, that black freedom is a pipe dream, black hope is a joke, and black love is a crime.